arts, I have found, are one of the best ways to teach and get through to people. When we were doing Hamilton, the feedback that we got was, if they had taught history class like this, with, you know, through song, we would have like understood everything. I showed up at UMass Amherst and had no sense that being a designer for the theater was really even a craft that I could do for the rest of my life. But once I had found that, I really became incredibly focused and was just seeking anything and everything that I could do to really grow what I thought would be my focus in my career. This is our version of a lab. I learned how to mix paint right there. They're learning how to mix paint. I learned how to use most of the power tools that we use in the industry here. And in the end, we build something where nothing was before. And we open up these massive doors and roll it out on stage for the audience to enjoy. I also spent a lot of time with this guy. Good to see you. This is Harley. He's the chair of the department and was and is one of my mentors. One of the memories that I have is that Theater 100 course, first day, first class, and you said the definition of theater is A performing B for C. Yeah. That's it. And I quote that all the time. I used this same exact trick when I did The Wiz at City Center, that same cable trick.
Oh my gosh.
Don't tell anyone or tell everyone, I don't care. Okay. I can't believe the capabilities of the shop have grown so much.
It really has, and we get a lot of work into the hands of the students, making things, designing things, realizing their designs.
It's really quite remarkable, and I feel like it just feels happy.
It does.
It feels so.
The new arts bridge, and it is literally a bridge across the building, but also it's a bridge between the different arts departments. We have a recording studio, music classrooms, art studios. The students feel it now, the feeling that arts are important at UMass, arts are central.
So Van Gogh is interesting for me because it was created by a guy named Massimiliano Sicardi, who's a very talented content creator in Italy. And he's been doing kind of projection and immersive projection design for 30 years. And when the producers wanted to kind of grow the experience, they came to me because I'm a kind of an omnidirectional world builder. So I took this film at the centerpiece of our experience, and then I built all sorts of activations and experiential things that would help people learn more while being entertained. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
And that is where entertainment is heading. People don't want just a straight-ahead theatrical production or a straight-ahead rock concert or a straight-ahead television show. All of the theatrical offerings are starting to become fully immersive. It's going to blur the line between what's real and what's not. To me, the thing that really balanced my education was the fact that I was getting real-world educational experiences and education at the same time. I would say if you're here, you should lean in and really say yes and be curious. This is such a big and sprawling and impressive place that you could find the answer to who you're gonna be and what you're going to do really anywhere. Keep your head up, keep your eyes open, and look for new and interesting opportunities. And I got a lot of that here at UMass.